casa, eu tenho
¿Qué es lo que?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sí.
Exactly 10 people in total can be in the church, which includes myself. After we check in the 10, even a person who is recording the ceremony. So the total number of people together was 10. So I suggest those who are here, you can stay on the outside and look here. But we have to follow the regulation in the space. We can only have 10 people. Dear brothers and sisters, to say it one more time, the total people in the church, it does not matter what is your function, the total persons in the church is only 10. So now that we have settled, I invite you to please stand as we begin this ceremony. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, in the waters of baptism, Monica died with Christ and rose with Christ. May she now come and share with Christ the eternal glory.
To carry everything to God. should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, humbled with the Lord of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends in the Christ forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he take and shield thee. Thou wilt find your solace there.
My dear brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. So let us pray for our sister Monica, that she may share in Christ's victory, and let us pray for ourselves that the Lord will grant us the gift of his loving consolation. So I invite you now to be seated as you listen to the news.
This is from our sister Judith, Auntie Monica, Auntie Lori, as we affectionately call her, was the fifth of eight children born to Carmen and Lori Adolphus Lafayette on January 29, 1931. Auntie Lori always wanted to be an elementary school teacher. So at the end of her elementary schooling, she stayed on as a monitor. Back then, that was how you started your journey to becoming a teacher. You worked alongside teachers who monitored and eventually recommended that you be given your own class. And that's where teaching career began. Unfortunately for Auntie Monica, the monitor program ended just before she became eligible to have her own class. Determined to pursue her dream, she enrolled in high school at the age of 20. There were others like her in that class at San Juan Secondary School whose dreams had been derailed by the ending of the monitor system. She would complete her secondary education, attend teacher training college, and teach in the elementary school system for over 30 years. Retiring as vice principal of the Braille Roman Catholic School. Monica is only one of her siblings to pursue tertiary education. She was a guiding light for her nieces and her children. Many of her nieces pursued a career in education at some point in their lives. We all wanted to be like Auntie Monica, educated women who worked at educating others.
Let us stand and pray. God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant number, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. It is easy as we listen to the word of God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live for the Lord. And if we die for the Lord, so that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God, as Scripture says, "By my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall praise God." It is to God, therefore, that each of us must give an account of himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we will sing the least consoling song on your program, "The Lord is My Shepherd."
Thank you.
revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to mere children. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, today for you family members, is a difficult day. For you family members, today is a sad day because a loved one, one whom you cherish, one you admire, has died, and we are doing the funeral rites. And that will bring about a certain amount of anxiety, even worry, grief, sadness, and pain. But we are to realize that God, through his love, has sent his Son into the world, that whoever dies like the Lord, the firstborn from the dead, Jesus Christ, will also rise from the dead. And that will be Monica Lott in life. Today also, August 27th, and I don't know if that is the reason why we chose this day for a funeral rites, because today the church celebrates Saint Monica. And Saint Monica was a woman of prayer, a woman who trusted in divine providence of Almighty God. So much so, she was a Christian, and her husband was a pagan, and her son was wayward. And in spite of the difficulty of her life with a difficult husband and a difficult son, she remained steadfast and faithful to Almighty God. She did what was expected of her to do, and because of her faithfulness, now she is numbered among those in heaven. She is given the title Saint. Well, the little heard in the eulogy of Monica, well, it sounds like she is on the right path to also become a Saint Monica also, because here was a woman who tirelessly did the things that she knew that was right and good. She was faithful, committed to her loved ones. She was faithful and committed even to her job. And she did it to the best of her abilities. And that is what God expects of each each and every one of us. That the things we do it to the best of our abilities. The first reading that was read from Romans, we are reminded that God will give to each and every one of us what our conduct deserves. And we are reflecting on the life of our sister, and we know how she conducted her life. She conducted her life in faithfulness. So this faithful child of God, we can be reassured that God will be faithful and she will reap the rewards of a blessing. What did the gospel say to us? Come to me, all who are labor and overburden, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. So we can be certain that our sister, her pilgrim journey on earth may have ended, but she will come to the Lord, and she will have the rest that she desires. Saint Monica, whom we celebrate today, her wayward son, because of his mother's faithfulness, he too became faithful, and he is numbered as a saint today. His name is Saint Augustine, and Saint Augustine have taught us a very important lesson. The lesson he has taught us, our souls are not at rest until it rests with thee, O Lord. And how will our souls be at rest with the Lord? Only if we come to him. So his mother, Saint Monica, taught him a life of faithfulness. This Monica, that whom we know, who I say may very well be on the path to also become a Saint Monica. What did she teach you all? What was her example? An example of faithfulness. So let us be consoled. Let us be comforted that God will take care of her. She simply did her best. God will take care of the rest. She couldn't do better than her best. Like Saint Augustine, learn from his Monica, his mother, to be faithful. What can we learn from this Monica? And if we learn the lesson of faithfulness, we too will experience the goodness of God. Because all of us, no matter who we are, we want goodness and mercy to follow us all the days of our life. And goodness and mercy can only follow us all the days of our life if we are faithful. So if it is anything you remember today as you say farewell to your loved one Monica, is this: she was faithful, and through her example may we all be faithful, so that we too will find rest when we come to the Lord. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, we have heard the word of God, we have reflected on it. Let us stand now and pray. And our response to our prayers is, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God, Almighty Father, raise Christ the Son from the dead, with confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. For Monica, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the families and friends of that they may be consoled in grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
I invite you now to make your own special prayer for our sister. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God, our shelter, our strength, you listen now to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for the departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So, my dear brothers and sisters, you may be seated. At this time, we continue with the Holy Mass in celebration of the Eucharist. Our sister remained faithful right up to the very moment of her death. So we celebrate now this Eucharist that she will share in the heavenly banquet at God's table.
Take all bread, we ask you, take all hearts, we love you, take all lives, O Father, we are yours, we are yours. Yours as we stand at the table you set, yours as we eat the bread our hearts can't forget. We are the signs of your life with us yet. We are yours. We are yours. Take our bread. We ask you. Take our hearts. We love you. Take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours. Your holy people standing washed in your blood. Spirit filled yet hungry, we await your food. We are poor, but we brought ourselves best we could. We are yours, we are yours. Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Martha, we beseech your mercy that she who died did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for as one alone he accepted death, so that he might all escape from dying, as one man who chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever, and so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and enjoy in your glory.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of glories, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. only there for this used to pray. Thy seven down your strength upon them, like the twofold. So they become fast the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of them, and eat of it, for this man's body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to Simon, saying, take this, all of them, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior, O Lord,
for by the cross and
resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your ability to be in your presence and listen to you. Humbly pray that by taking of the body of Christ, you regard as one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, strengthen our will, and bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jason, our Bishop, and all your clergy. Remember all sorrows and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we are merited to prayers to eternal life, and praise and glorify him through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in you, O God, my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace our aid, that thy love and your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we have made the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on faith in your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. The Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are suffering of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter the house, but when you say the word, my soul shall be healed.
So we have all received the blessing of the Holy Mass, but only those who have made their first Holy Communion in the Catholic Church can receive the body of Christ. Time we know her body is dead. So we are going to commit a soul to our Almighty God.
Thank you.
whatever sin she has committed through human weakness, and your goodness grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So my dear brothers and sisters, I invite you to stand. And at this time, I'm going to commit a body to the earth, because we are praying, and as incense rises up, so we trust that our soul, like incense, will rise to Almighty God. So now we are going to commit a body to the earth. Because God has chosen to call our sister from this life himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Amen. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
say goodbye to her.
When he calls me someday, my
Thank you.
drink this morning. Well, but you have to replenish the drink again. This whole thing came for again. Now what kind of meat? Middleman, come on. Middleman, still.
You can't go now. I'll see you in the middle, man.
Alright, switch hands now. You don't switch hands, did it?
Yeah.
Raise up and don't put those down. Raise the box. Yeah, raise the box.
Just as Somebody playing something? Come on, everybody, put your hands together. It's got to get better all over the world. I'm seeing them. 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 I'